North Korea's Master Brandon Tucker of the White House and Defense Institutional Research is really good happening now. It's not drawn to analyze these numbers a tad bit more. Hi, Gaurav. Thanks very much for joining in. It's been a subdued quarter for the company now. What have you made of the cautious tone which the management had set yesterday in their analyst meet, especially in terms of demand?
You're right that this has been a very subdued quarter for the company, and like this is the second successful quarter wherein they've reported a low single digit kind of a growth rate. So I think demand conditions continue to remain weak. So and largely for the discretionary space, I think overall demand scenario has not seen a pickup. So I think we have resulted in a subdued second half of FY15 for the company. Management is still not seeing any change in terms of improvement in the scenario on the ground, and this is the reason why the stance of the management has been cautious. But our thesis has been that with an pickup in the macro, I think urban discretionary demand will have to pick up, and that will actually fuel in the demand for some of the discretionary categories like paint, and office Asian Paints would be a beneficiary. So we think that FY16 should be better for the company both in terms of volume growth as well as margin performance for Asian Paints.
Okay, so just to get in some numbers, what is your volume growth expectation and how much margin expansion are you building in for FY16 for the company?
For FY15, we have done a high single digit kind of a volume growth. So my single digit volume growth would be somewhere in the range of 8 to 9%. Do you think that there is a scope for improvement by a couple of percentage points? I think for FY16, we should be somewhere around 10 to 11% kind of a volume growth number.
Okay, earlier there, now for 2 quarters, the company has been reporting strong gross margin expansion, but yesterday, the management has pointed out that these levels of over 45% may be the peak, and they may not actually be sustainable here on. So how much of a year risk to earnings could be there in the back of this?
Yes, so if you listen to the management, they've mostly been cautious in terms of the margin performance. So they generally don't dive at all in terms of margins or gross margins. But yeah, they made a commentary that gross margins at around 45% could be a new SMP. If the raw material basket as well as the INR remains stable, we think that a similar kind of margins should be achievable in FY16. So if you look at the quarter's performance also, the gross margins on a year-on-year basis have improved by 300 plus basis points. The only reason why the EBITDA margins did not improve are some of the losses in the home improvement business in the control entity, as well as operating leverage not appearing on account of a lower top line growth. So if your top line growth is 0.6%, your cost largely would grow in double digits. So this has impacted your EBITDA margin performance. But if in FY16 your top line growth improves, we think that EBITDA margin should also improve in line with sales growth margins. So we think that over FY15 to FY17, there should be around 300 odd basis point improvement in EBITDA margins from current 15% levels to somewhere be able to 18% levels.
And that's quite an estimation, but we are getting mixed demand trends from consumer companies, you know, whether this slowdown is more rural than urban in nature. And also, while sluggish rural demand will be a risk due to unseasonal rains, is it fair to say that this dip in demand is largely urban?
You have rightly said that the slowdown currently is largely urban. So if you look at for most of the companies, rural demand continues to outpace urban demand, although the gap continues to narrow. But I think maybe rural demand would not see a material slowdown if you have a normal monsoon and MSP rises as well as some of the social security spends done by the government. Then in that case, we would see a stable kind of a rural growth. But urban growth would be the key driver for most of the companies, especially in the discretionary space. So maybe your paint companies, your footwear companies, or your QSR companies like Jubilant, urban demand revival would be a key. So our sense is that rural demand on a high base could at least stabilize or see a marginal tapering off. But urban demand will actually pick up and fill in the gap of somewhat slowdown in the rural demand.
And while you are now, the other thing we have to watch out for this week is going to be ITC. So given all the negative news flow that we have around the stock, we've seen a double-digit volume dip for CIDX in Q3. So will the performance in Q4 be similar, you think?
Right, so ITC proposed the hike in excise duty in the union budget. We had downgraded the stock from a buy to a hold. We still would not prefer the stock, given that the discounter as well, the cigarette volumes will decline in double digits. So we expect around 10-11% kind of a volume regrowth. So I think overall top line as well as earnings growth would be low single digit. And valuations haven't corrected materially for the stock. So the stock would still be trading at somewhere in line with the historic average multiples. So ITC, we would avoid and we have a very negative on the stock as of now.